Hello Gamer Enjoys, this is your host Docket24, and I'm signing in for the start of Let's Play Resident Evil the Remake in PS4 console. What do you think of this background? It looks very amazing, doesn't it? It could have had Chris in it, but oh well. So this happens to be the New Game Plus playthrough. This is what's with Resident Evil Zero, that is Origins Collection. I'm gonna play this once again. This playthrough happens to be the New Game Plus playthrough. This game is either in two playlists. Either it's in
Resident Evil.
Either it's in Origins Collection or it's on its own. You guys will know where it is from. So here, I'm gonna be selecting Jill because ladies first. I've emptied things in a trash can because the first time I tried that, it automatically stopped because of no space.
Alpha team is flying around the forest zone, situated in northwest Raccoon City, where we are searching for the helicopter of our compatriots, Bravo team, who disappeared during the middle of their mission.
Haven't found it yet?
No, not yet.
Bizarre murder cases have recently occurred in Raccoon City. There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people. Victims were apparently eaten. The Bravo team was sent in to investigate, but we lost contact.
Look, Chris!
Bravo team's helicopter was a derelict. Save for the remaining body of Kevin. We continued our search for the other members, and it turned into a nightmare.
This way.
There are only three STARS members left now. Captain Wesker, Barry, and myself. We don't know where Chris is.
What is this place?
Not quite your ordinary house, that's for sure.
Hey, Wesker, where's Chris?
Jill, no! You don't want to go back out there.
But we've got to find...
What was that?
Chris?
No.
Jill, go and investigate.
I'm going with her. Chris and I go back a long way.
All right. You two go. I'll secure this area.
Stay sharp. A dining room.
Alright, excuse me for a second. Okay, I'm back. I had to clear things in the laptop.
I think you'd better take a look at this.
What is it?
Blood. Jill, see if you can find any other clues. I'll be examining this. Let's just hope it's not Chris's.
So, we meet Barry in this game, who he appears back in Resident Evil Revelations 2. Then we meet Jill in this game, where in who she appears back in Resident Evil Revelations and Resident Evil 5. I'll tell you more after this cutscene, after we've done everything here.
That gunfire. I'm counting on you to investigate, Jill.
Sure thing, Wesker. Barry.
So Jill is apparently in partner with Barry, so we just examine this door again.
Got cold feet already? That's not like you.
Who is it?
You! Freeze! Get away from him, Jill! He's insane! What the hell?
We better report this to Wesker.
So, let's go and, to Wesker. So instead of holding down circle for D-pad, we're using square for D-pad. You know, full 10, running from left and running from right.
Wesker! Jill, help me look for him. Let's not leave this hall.
Good idea.
So, unlike in Resident Evil Zero with the buttons, instead of, using R1 to aim and X to fire, we're using L1 to aim and R1 to fire. And instead of clicking square to go to the menu, that is the selection, the inventory, we're using triangle. So, it's kind of weird, but it's very riveting to see.
Barry.
Any luck, Jill?
No, nothing. What's going on around here? I can't figure it out.
Same here.
Chris, and now Wesker.
There's not much we can do. We can search for him separately. I'll investigate the dining room again.
Okay, then. I'll try the door on the other side.
This mansion is gigantic. We could easily get lost. Let's start from the first floor.
Okay.
Oh! I almost forgot. It's a lockpick. You'd make better use of it.
Thanks. I may need it.
Listen. If something happens, let's meet up in this hall. Got it?
Okay.
So, when we look at our inventory, we have the Samurai Edge. The Infinite Handgun is what I like to call Samurai Edge, so there are ways on how to unlock both of them. So if you complete the game under 5 hours, you will unlock the Infinite Handgun and the Closet Key. But if you complete the game under 3 hours, you will unlock the Infinite Rocket Launcher. Either that, you can unlock both if you're not going to want to complete it under 5 hours, so that's what it is. Emergency Evade. Using defensive items such as daggers will allow you to escape momentarily when grabbed by an enemy. However, you will not be able to escape when the enemy grabs you from behind. To equip a defensive items, go to the status screen and then select an item from the defensive item menu. Then select the equip command. If your defensive item mode is set to manual in the controller settings, you must press L2 to use the defensive items. Oops. Alright, so let's go make a run for it. I don't know why we have to keep grabbing infinite handgun ourselves. It's just kind of weird. I am forced to use the rocket launcher. It's just very annoying. Because the infinite handgun, I'm using it against zombies and Cerberus. That is what the dog is called. And the rest in this game, I'm using rocket launcher, even for bosses. Okay, we got the map. Let's get off and go through this door. So unlike in Resident Evil 0 where they have 6 slots, here in Resident Evil 1 the remake, Jill has 8 slots. Kind of weird. I'm just trying to avoid using rocket launcher. That's one rocket launcher I'm using to the zombie because I didn't have a choice, and the handgun is in the item box. Yep, I'll take the green herb. So the yellow herb is only in Resident Evil 4. If you haven't seen the playlist of it, better check it out now. So we're grabbing an arrow. Taking the golden one. Okay, examine an item. From the status screen, select an item and then select the examine command. The details of the item will be displayed. Oh crap! Yeah, that's one reason why we are using the dagger. We've unlocked it from the other side, which means the other side was locked. We don't need to push the statue. Over there's a blue gem. When you push the statue, when you see the one there's no bar, you push it off and then you get the blue gem. Alright, let's go through this door and we'll be perfectly fine. Run off and examine it. Arrowhead. Whoops. Now we can use it. See the one that's carved? We can plug this. I mean, not plug this in. We can put it in just so that we go down there for the secret area. The book is fitted perfectly in the indentation. Book of Curse. And we examine this, and if we look at the back, is the key emmed on the back cover. And I shall remove it. That's the mansion key. And we read the book. Book of Curse. The four masks. A mask that speaks no evil, a mask that smells no evil, a mask that sees no evil, a mask that doesn't do three things evil. When all four fall into place, evil will awaken. Alright. Now we just go and get up there. Whew, that was a close one. Go past the zombie by going at its back, and then you'll be fine. You could use a bit of a shotgun if you have one. Once the game asks you, do you want to get rid of it, always answer yes. So here's where we're going to use a key. Nothing out there, but it's very useful. Oh, and I just realized I'm just gonna... there. Got the dagger key. So there are two things Jill uses, the defensive items. She uses the dagger and she uses the stun gun. The amazing thing about Jill is that she can pick locks. Unlike the other character where you have to find an old key just to unlock it. Terrible. But we found a dagger. And it's not dirty. Okay, this is, combine this, combine that. And that's a fact. Got a chemical to use plants. With 8 slots, that's tricky, but unlike the other character who has 6 slots, it's a bit hard. And we find another dagger. Yeah, I'm collecting daggers, all of this one. Taking the shotgun, and we're gonna get out of here. So we examine the two doors.
Oh God, what did I do now?
Wesker! Barry! Help!
Jill! You in there?
Barry? Get me out of here! The door's jammed!
Stand back! Grab my hand!
Barry.
That was a close one. A second late, you would have fit nicely into a sandwich.
Really? Thanks. But Barry, didn't you say you were going back to the dining room to find other clues? I'm glad and all, but why are you here?
I just had something I wanted to check. Anyway, we should get back to searching for Wesker and Chris.
Thanks, Barry. I owe you one.
Don't mention it.
Okay. We just, so we found out the line. Jill Sandwich. It was also used in the original. If you guys played it before. Oh, crap. Yeah, it's one reason why I'm using a dagger. We get to take the canteen. And, there we go. Special instructions for the disposal of dead bodies. We have new information regarding those being. They may appear to be dead, but in fact they are able to come back to life. However, there are ways to prevent them from becoming active again. Currently, there are 2 known methods to cease their resurrection. 1, incineration. 2, destruction of the head, which means you blow their heads off. If further methods are discovered, you will be notified immediately. Meanwhile, to those of you who still have the will to live, oil has been placed on the first floor of the mansion. Take as much as you need. You'll need something to light it with, which you'll need to find by yourself. Okay, so we just found the canteen. You'll only burn their bodies if you How do I say it? Like, you'll find the bodies like a dead body of a zombie. So, if you find the dead body of a zombie... So, if you see the dead body of a zombie, you can burn it using canteen, but you also need a lighter to equip. Get your lighters equipped, and then you have both, canteen and lighter. So there are two fuels for this. So once you burn their bodies, they will also come back to life as the flaming dangerous one. Once their head is blown, you have nothing to worry about. Unlocked it from the other side. Run. Oh, come on. Stay down already. When Jill still auto-aims, even though the zombie is lying down, that means they're still alive, so that comes useful. Taking dog whistle, a crumpled memo. Today, Sir Spencer told me to hide something where no one could find it. Well, I had this idea. I figured if I could somehow have it protected by a dangerous animal like the vicious canine that lives here, no one would be able to get near it. As far as I can tell, the mud is always hanging around the second floor balcony on the west side of the terrace, and he ought to come running at the sound of a dog whistle. This is where you come in. The thing is, I reckon you're the only person that can get near that damn dog without risking a serious mauling. Which means only you can put this collar on him. The object that Sir Spencer wants hidden is concealed inside. You're the only person I can trust with this. Of course, you'll get something out of it as well. Remember that certain item that you've always wanted to get hold of? Well, in exchange for your service, I just might be able to get it for you. This could work out well for both of us, John Tolman. And along with it, we have the lighter. Okay, we use the mansion key just to get out of here.
Barry.
Jill, got any good news?
Other than I'm still alive in this madhouse? No.
Can't say it's much safer here either. We'd better secure our escape route first. There's gotta be a back door somewhere.
All right then, let's split up again.
Hey, hold on a sec. Look what I've found.
What?
A can of fizz. It's sure to yellow and mellow those things. It's yours. Hopefully you won't have to use it.
Okay, we got the acid shell.
What about you?
Oh, don't worry. I like the buddy system we have here.
I see. Thanks. I'll take it.
See you later.
Ciao.
So we have this yellow stuff, which means the only way for it is to like go through this door. When you hear that clinging fast sound, that means there's a zombie that only appears in New Game Plus. So the one that only appears in New Game Plus is called Grenade Zombie. You don't shoot at it because obviously if you do, then it's going to cause the whole mansion to blast to bits and that will be game over. Before I use the whistle, let me unlock it from the other side. Alright, now we can go back and use the whistle. The dog whistle, that is. Oh, come on. Okay, we got the dog key. So I think this is for the grenade launcher, I think. Yeah, discard that one. Okay, let's see, yeah, we don't need a can of fizz thing. Actually, we'll come back later. Oh, come on. Sometimes the camera is just being your enemy. Picking a lock. Before we go down there, we have to go this way. Use the lockpick. Something I gotta show you. There's the stun gun, the battery pack. And this one is the broken shotgun. You can pick it up and replace it with the shotgun that was holding there. That's the other way. Just so that the line doesn't happen. Okay, we just put it there. Nothing is, terrible. If you tap the square a bit faster, you can go up a bit fast. Okay. Let's just, Alright, so we go up there and take this key. This is the real key because you see there's no two pointy things. So you can replace the real key with the imitated key, and it's in this dog collar. flick the switch, reveals some kind of a coin shape, in which it shapes a square. And as we examine the back one, it reveals to be the change of a shape of a key, the imitation key. Now we can use the imitation key just so that we get to take the other one. Okay, so now that we've got the herb with us, we go and go back the way we came. By the way, the zombie that just came to life, whatever, that zombie is called Crimson Head. Once the zombie is dead for a few seconds, it'll come back to life as Crimson Head. I will have this, I have this Eclipse 2 immense, so if you hear my sound going different, that's my, that's the chewing mint I'm taking. Alright. Let's do it. Put it in. Alright, so let's go and see where. Go down there and, oh gosh, this stupid zombie! Stupid grenade zombie! Yeah, discard that, please. That's one reason why we are getting rid of this key. Okay, that's fine. Let's go there. Oh gosh, this is not good. Okay, we've blown the head off. Let's get the heck out of here. Okay, we use the mansion key. Let's just go and get through this door since we're here. Alright, let's examine this paper. Okay, Keeper's Diary. May 9th, 1998. Played poker tonight with Scott and Elias from security and Steve from research. Steve was the big winner, but I think he was cheating. Scumbag. May 10th, 1998. One of the hires up assigned me to take care of a new creature. It looks like a skinned gorilla. Feeding instructions were to give it live animals. When I threw in a pig, the creature seemed to play with it, tearing off the pig's legs and pulling out the guts before it actually started eating. May 11th, 1998. At around 5 a.m., Scott woke me up. Scared the shit out of me, too. He was wearing a protective suit. He handed me another one and told me to put it on. Said there'd be an accident in the basement lab. I just knew something like this would happen. Those bastards in research never sleep, even on holiday. May 12, 1998. I've been wearing the damn space suits since yesterday. My skin's getting grimy and feels itchy all over. Oh, grimy, sorry. I'm not good with pronouncings. The goddamn dogs have been looking at me funny, so I decided not to feed them today. Screw them. May 13th, 1998. Went to the infirmary because my back is all swollen and feels itchy. They put a big bandage on it and told me I didn't need to wear the suit anymore. All I want to do is sleep. May 14th, 1998. Found another big blister on my foot this morning. I ended up dragging my foot all the way to the dog's pen. They were quiet all day, which is weird. Then I realized some of them had escaped. Maybe this is their way of getting back at me for not feeding them the last 3 days. If anybody finds out, I'll have my head handed to me. May 16th, 1998. Rumors going around that researchers who tried to escape the estate last night was shot. My entire body feels hot and itchy, and I'm sweating all the time now. I scratched the swelling on my arm, and a piece of rotten flesh just dropped off. What the hell's happening to me? May 19, 1998. Fever gone, but itchy. Today hungry and eating doggy food. May 21st, 1998. Itchy, itchy. Scott came ugly face, so killed him. Tasty. //. Itchy, tasty. Okay, that's kind of weird. Got the battery pack. Ooh, that was a close one. Alright, now let's go and get out of here before the zombies come. Okay, let's just go and with these ones and okay, let's use this seed. And we use the lid on this water pump is open. Pump the water? Yes. Which way will you turn the switch? Red, because these ones do not like blood. They think it's blood. So these ones are called fountain plants. And I think they're dead. Since they're dead, we get to pick up more herbs. The heck? All right, let's combine and another combine. Okay, we've got the mask, death mask. Oh boy. So by the way, when unlocking these weapons, it'll only happen either normal or hard. Because I don't think it makes a difference It's only easy you cannot complete this game. It's either normal or hard. That's the only thing I can give it to you. Oh crap, I just realized I need to put things back. There's no point of carrying the herb with me, so I'm just putting it back. The grenade zombies is here. How I can tell is because of that sound. The footsteps, the clunking footsteps, I think. I don't know what you guys call it, but that's what it is. So let's put this down below. Don't know what's the next one. Okay, I just... saw that coming. Now, this is, a bit unusual. It's kind of like later I'm just finding... a bit unnerving. I was like wondering, when will this mansion key be thrown out? It turns out it just doesn't seem like it is going to. I'm just using a mansion key just to unlock all of them. Okay, let's go through it anyways, and we go there and we find the mask. So the answer to this one, on this side we turn it yellow. Then the other side, we turn it green. And as for the other side, we turn it purple. That's what we're gonna do. So we examine this one. Lisa protected by the three spirits. A picture of a woman wearing a bracelet, a necklace, and a crown. There's a switch at the bottom of the picture. Press it? Yes, please. Which means we find another mask. We pick the lock, use the lockpick, but we go back because it's quite closer. Just ignore these crows because they're no use for it now. hyperspray. So we'll just put a mask away for now. Oh crap! And yet, it's still here with us. I don't know why, but... it's just weird.
Richard! What happened? You're wounded!
This whole place is a killing zone. There are monsters.
What did this to you?
A big snake. And it had to be poisonous.
Poisonous? Richard, hold on.
Bring me serum. I saw some, but didn't bring any.
I'll go and get it, okay? You're gonna make it.
Thanks.
Oh dear. Okay, so we know where that is. Make sure you bring the serum straight away, because if you delay or if you take too long, don't make it right before 4 minutes happening, then Richard will instantly die. So, and when he dies, you don't get the Heist shotgun. So we just take a shortcut and the heck? Sometimes D-pads are just really struggling. They don't confuse us when the camera does not become your enemy. Ooh, that nearly got us. Okay. That was just annoying when that is happening. Okay, let's just get the serum and get out of there. Let's go and run towards it. Run up. So that's twice you will go through the door where the doorknob is about to fall off, but three times you won't be able to. I haven't saved this game. I think I'll save this game I'll only save this game once I've done streaming this one. Well, not literally done, but like if I've ended this one, like if I've ended this video. Oops, making sure I don't go the wrong way.
Here, Richard, I'm gonna give you a shot. Hang in there.
Jill. Here's my radio. Take it. I'm... Does it ever not hurt?
Okay, so now that we've sorted that out, we go and get to it. Whoa! I hear that squish sound. That means their head has been blown off. Okay, let's go and use the lighter. Oh gosh. Come on, just grab. Ooh, that was a close one. So we got the musical thing. Very important musical. I'm gonna leave the herbs for now. Because we haven't got to the boss yet. Wait, how many? Okay, yeah, that's fine. Come on, get to the stairs. So as we go through the door, we pick up the shield. That's where we get a chance to pick it up. So we got the rusted shield. So let's go through this door and push. So once we got that, we combine it. So we just use the piano with the book. So we find something here, and Trevor's diary. November 24, 1967. 11 days have passed since arriving on this estate. How did I end up like this? A guy in a lab coat brought me a merged plate of food and said, "Sorry to put you through this, but it's for security reasons." That's when it hit me. It all makes sense now. There are only two people that know the secret of this mansion, Sir Spencer and myself. If they kill me, Sir Spencer will be the only person that knows the secret. But for what purpose? It doesn't matter now. It's too dangerous here. My family, I hope they're all right. I've decided to escape. Jessica, Lisa, I pray you are safe. November 26, 1967. How could I be so careless? I lost my favorite lighter, the one Jessica gave me for my birthday. Now it's going to be that much harder to escape this dark place. November 13th, the date when my fate was sealed. My aunt was hospitalized just 3 days before that. Jessica and Lisa said they were going to visit her. I wish I could be there with them. But wait, even as I'm writing, my memory is coming back to me more vividly. Just before I passed out, I remember that man in the lab coats said something like, "Most likely your favorite is all ready." I pray for their safety. November 27, 1967. Somehow I managed to get out of that room, but getting out of this mansion won't be as easy. I have to get past all the booby traps, tiger eyes, gold emblems. I have to try and remember for my own sake. Okay, so here we've got the gold emblem, which means we're going to be using the brown. Well, not the brown, the rusted one. So let's use it. Okay, let's go examine the clock. So we're gonna move the clock and we're gonna move the large gear to the right or backwards. Oh, no. I've just gotten so greedy and went very quickly. Large. Left. Oh, no. Large. Large. Left. Large. Left. The answer is 6 o'clock. We've got this, another mansion key. But that's gonna get rid of easily. So we're getting closer to the boss encounter. Because as soon as we find the boss encounter, that's going to be the thumbnail of this video. Come on. What's going on? Okay, it's now 1 hour and we haven't found the boss, but we will soon. I'm gonna equip this grenade launcher, but you guys need a shotgun for this boss. Yes, please. And we have the boss encounter. This is round one. Round two is gonna happen later, so this is round one. This snake is called Yon.
Payback time.
Why it's called Yon? Probably Yon, but that's the first boss encounter. Oh, jeez. for once, Richard is killed by a snake, we pick up this heist shotgun called the Riot Shotgun, or Pump Shotgun. This is the highest level that you're gonna need, so you get to say goodbye to the lower shotgun now. So this is round one. Round two is gonna happen later, much later, I suppose. So for that, that's the end of this video. So for that, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, go to like. If you have some thoughts to share, put it in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe to this video and click the notification bell if you want to be notified. This is your host, Darker24, signing off. Right after I've saved this game, or I've gotten to the save point. Alright, so hang on. Well, let's just go through this door. After I get the other mask. So it's this one. Then it's the other one. And then the other one. The other one's already been done. So inside a box is a mask. Yes, please. Man, why does it keep stopping her from running? What the hell is going on? Okay, let's go. I think I'm just gonna... I'm just gonna combine this one. Almost there. Oh crap! Buzz off. Oh, get lost, get lost, get lost. Let's put the lighter away. We don't need it. This one. Let's put, examine. It's heart to press the switch, then the other heart. Okay, we've got all four masks. So for that, Save the progress. And there we go. I deeply apologize for the long delays of saving the game. Alright. There we go. Oh, stop that! Alright. Take care and peace out.